So find the Laplace transform of the function. The function was given as f of t is equal to, this was divided into two parts, e sine omega t, e sine omega t when 0 less than t less than pi by omega. Amit, you can check your mic. And the second part is equal to 0, pi by omega 2. T less than 2 pi by omega. Right? So this is how actually it is. Now see this actually, this is within the range of 0 to pi by omega. And this is within the range of pi by omega to 2 pi by omega. And this is being the periodic waveform. So this is the periodic waveform. Now for finding the Laplace transform of any periodic waveform is L of f of t is equal to, so this value is 1 by 1 minus e power minus s into the period of the waveform. Now what is the period of the waveform here? What is the period? So here actually st, so that is the period actually we have to be giving it. Any other? Right? Yeah. So that is correct. So 2 pi by omega. So this is the period. Because actually it started from 0 and it ended with 2 pi by omega. So 2 pi by omega is the range. So there actually the period actually you shouldn't be considered only the waveform wherever it is present. Suppose if the waveform is like this, let us say. Suppose this is how the waveform is. Then actually in this particular case, the period is from here to here. So in this particular range actually, though the functional value is 0, but the pattern of this waveform and this 0, this waveform and this 0, this pattern continues. So hence actually this value is 2 pi by omega. And this is actually the half of that, that is pi by omega. Got it? So this is how actually this will continue, the time period. So this is the time period t is equal to, and this is the t equal to. Now here actually from here to here, this is 2 pi by omega, which is nothing but the capital T value. So this is 2 pi by omega. Got it? So 1 by 1 minus e power minus st, and then actually integral 0 to 2 pi by omega and f of t dt. So this is the Laplace transform of, right? So integral 0 to 2 pi by omega e power minus st into f of t dt. So this value actually we have to be finding out. But this range actually can be divided into two different sections. One to the pi by omega and another is pi by omega to 2 pi by omega. So this equation is the Laplace transform of f of t is equal to 1 by 1 minus e power minus s into 2 pi by omega into integral 0 to pi by omega. And this is e sine omega t, right, dt plus integral pi by omega to 2 pi by omega, and this is 0 into dt. So this is e power minus st. Yeah. So this value actually we have to be finding out. So this is being 0, so this is anyway 0, and this value actually we have to be finding out the integral value. And if you notice, this is actually e is anyway constant, it comes out, and e power minus st into sine omega t. So e power minus st into sine omega t value we have to be finding out. So I hope everybody aware of that formula. So there is one derivation for that. That derivation at plus 2 standard itself actually you might have done. I will give the formula straight away. You can use it. You don't need to derive that. So e power at sine bt dt integral. So any integral of this format, and the answer is straight away you can write as e power at divided by a square plus b square, then a sine bt minus b cos bt. So this is the formula, this you can remember it. So at plus 2 standard, actually, there is one big derivation to prove this. So this actually you can make use of it. Now in that actually integral 0 to pi by omega and e into e power minus st into sine omega t dt, right? So this is e power a t sine bt format. So this actually e is anyway you can take it out, and then whatever is left over is e power minus st divided by s square plus omega square and a sine bt. So a is minus s sine omega t minus b cos bt. B is omega cos of omega t. Now this value, the limits you can substitute it. The limits actually 0 to pi by omega. And this value you can substitute it and put it in the final format. So the answer is, you can note down, e omega divided by one minus e power minus pi s by omega. 1 minus e power minus pi s by omega into s square plus omega square. Right? So this value after the substitution you will arrive at this final answer. Got it? Any questions on this? Any questions? Fine? Okay. So let us go to the next level. Yeah. Okay. Great. So now actually today I'm going to discuss some of the important theorems which are useful, and if you know those theorems actually you can say that actually you are done with that Laplace transforms finding out. So not the inverse Laplace transform, at least. So the way we find out the Laplace transform mostly depends on these theorems, right? So that is actually, if you multiply with t the function, then what would be the Laplace transform? If you divide with t, then what would be the Laplace transform? If you do the derivative, what would be the Laplace transform of it? If you do the integration, what would be the Laplace transform of it? So all such kind of scenarios we are going to discuss it today. Got it? So y zero to pi by omega, y not zero to 2 pi by omega. So the function itself says, right? So integral 0 to 2 pi by omega, actually we have taken y because during that range actually the functional value is e sine omega t. From pi by omega to 2 pi by omega, the value is 0. The function value itself is 0. Hence actually it is treated as 0. So that is a half wave function. So out of the complete sine wave, one half is described, rest of the half is 0. Got it? Fine? Now the Laplace transforms of the derivative of a function. Right? Now this value, the theorem says that if f dash of t be continuous, and if f dash of t be continuous and Laplace transform of f of t is equal to f bar of s, then Laplace transform of f dash of t is equal to, then Laplace transform of the derivative of this particular function is equal to s into f bar of s minus f of 0 minus f of 0. Yeah, that is correct. Right? Now actually let us find out the Laplace transform of the derivative of any particular function. Got it? See, while defining the Laplace transform by definition, if e power minus st into t, so in that actually e power minus st is there, right? When you substitute t is equal to infinite, that is going to lead to the finite value of 0. So that is the basic definition when we define the Laplace transform. Got it? So then only actually we say that the Laplace transform exists for that. Got it? So any particular function, so e power minus st f of t, whatever may be the function of it, limit as t tends to infinite, this will be zero. So this is actually the basic definition while defining the Laplace transform. So this you don't need to know extra. Got it? So you can always treat as zero. Is this understood? Then only we can define the Laplace transform. Okay. So now the Laplace transform of f dash of t. So this value is equal to integral 0 to infinity e power minus st into f dash of t dt. So this is the Laplace transform. Right now, when we find the Laplace transform of it, now here actually the function derivative was given. Now what we do is, so if you apply the bipartite rule, so integral u dv is equal to uv minus integral v du. Now this is how actually the bipartites are going to be done. Now I have given the one more variation of this bipartites, that is, this can always be treated as uv minus u dash v1 plus u double dash v2 minus u triple dash v3 plus dash 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 up to infinity. So this is how actually you can write the chain rule in the case of the bipartites. Now here actually in this case, if you notice e power minus st, let us call this u is equal to e power minus st and dv is equal to f dash of t into dt. Now from this, if you find the integral of it, v is going to be of f of t. So v value is f of t. Now here this equation can be written as e power minus st into f of t minus integral v du. So v is f of t and du is nothing but this one. So du by dt is equal to minus s into e power minus st. Then du can be written as, so du is equal to minus s into e power minus st into dt. So in this actually you can substitute it. So this is going to be of f of t into e power minus st into minus s into dt. Got it? So I have just applied this bipartite principle on this particular one by taking u is equal to this portion and v is equal to this portion. So I found the v value and then actually I substituted in this equation. Then actually we left with this one. Now if you put it in a simpler format, the Laplace transform of f dash of t, and this is equal to e power minus st into f of t minus, so integral, and this minus actually you can take it out. So this is going to be of plus s and then actually e power minus st into f of t dt. Now if you notice, this is nothing but the Laplace transform of the function f of t, f of t. So this can be replaced with f bar of s. So this is the limits you can substitute as 0 to infinity, and this value you can simply replace as s into f bar of s. So s into f bar of s. Now this value after substitution of the limits as per the definition I have given, so this is whatever may be the value of this particular function e power minus st as t tending to infinite, this will always leads to 0. So in that case actually 0 minus e power minus 0 is nothing but 1 into f of 0. So this value is going to be of, so 0 minus f of 0 plus s into f bar of s, or this can even be written as s into f bar of s minus f of 0. So this is the value of the Laplace transform of the derivative of the function. Got it? Any questions on this? Is there any question on this? Right, I hope you understood clearly. Yeah, great. Right, so now the same kind of discussion can be extended to any level of the derivative. So this is actually only the first derivative we have taken.